Good morning, Millikin. This is Patrick Hoban, a Millikin alumni, doing another video for you guys. This will be the last video. This is going to be about content creation. So far we talked about how to find content using RSS feeds. We found out how to share some of that information and those links and articles on LinkedIn, and then best practices for Twitter too. So today we're going to talk about how to create our own content instead of sharing everybody else's. So we're going to end up switching over to my screen so we can take a look at some of the easiest ways to create your own content. Easiest way by far is photos. So Instagram's a really easy way, not only to create photos for Instagram, but also for your other sites. So just because it's on here doesn't mean you can't share it on LinkedIn or Twitter or anywhere else. Going back to the brand and the industry that I was in, or still am actually, it's economic development. So what we've got in economic development is I always wanted to be known for being around whenever development was happening. So with that, anytime there was a groundbreaking in town, anytime that there was any kind of development news, I always wanted to be there and get pictures so we could share that information. Because unfortunately, in today's society, it seems like a lot of the bad information gets out pretty quick. But as far as good news goes, that's harder to sell. And my generation especially, they're not really paying attention to the radio or the news, maybe more so now, but not really locally. So no one in Decatur that was I graduated with really knew about all the wonderful things and investment that was happening. So I utilized social media to share some of that good news. Here's one of the groundbreakings for one of your new buildings, which that's gone now. And also a bonus for this is adding the text on top of it. There's an app that you can use called Fonto. And Fonto, I think it's like $1.99, not sure. But you can add that. So whenever you take your photos, slap the text on top of it, basically making it a meme, and then sharing it from there. If you want to get a little more advanced, create a blog. I mean, just start writing. You guys have hobbies. You're experts at something so far. And if you're not, you can always do research, start cranking out more content. A couple different platforms to talk about. I've used a lot of these. WordPress.org, there's a way that you can create a free blog. And actually, I think it's kind of funny because I typed in, I think, beginner's guides for blogging, and WordPress did their own. And of course, they ranked themselves number one. Another one, Constant Contact, I do use more for emailing purposes. HostGator is a host that I used to use to host my websites. WordPress.com, if you want to pay, you can use WordPress's instead of WordPress.org. Blogger is Google's version, and it's free. So if you guys just want to get started, start writing right away, I'd recommend checking out Blogger. Tumblr is one that you guys probably already know about, actually, but it's actually blogging software. So you can do a lot with Tumblr to start cranking out just on your phone right now. One that I'm fond of immediately is Medium. I've been using that for a little while, a couple different blogs here and there. I'm trying to go through a technique where I can write a book that I actually learned from Smashing Magazine, which is a blog that I follow. Smashing, I've been following for a while. It's a marketing, advertising blog. The funny thing about Smashing is they take all these blog posts and then they put them in different categories, and then they actually publish them as books. And then people like me, even though that the articles are already on here, buy the books. And so you're slowly writing a book over time on whatever you want to be known for, from your blog. So if you want to just start writing, getting your thoughts on paper, creating your own content, getting it out there, and then you organize it later on, and you can write your own book and crank it out as a PDF. And that always looks good on a resume that you have published a book. You can turn around and crank those out on Amazon as well. One of them that I started a while ago and actually kind of got lost in the mix of all my transitions between communities was a Medium blog that was called Exceeding Average. It was just a way, just advice for my younger self, basically, because I ended up coaching football there in Decatur for a little while. And I really did it because I wanted to give back and hopefully, you know, keep some of these kids from making some of the mistakes that I made in the past. But Exceeding Average is a book I still want to write. And it's just basically mind, body, and goals, life lessons for my younger self. But if you create any blog, the cool thing is if you go back to Feedly, whenever you go to add something, you can create your blog and add it into Feedly. So just like all the other blogs or news articles you guys are pulling from, you can pull from your own and share those as well. So the theory would be write it on the blog first, write your content, then go back into Feedly and then share it from there. So it goes back onto LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, whatever you're using for that topic. And if you're wanting to know what to write about, I receive a question on, you know, looking forward to what kind of content. Always stay relevant. You never want to be that person that's just sitting there screaming about whatever it is that you're interested in. You need to talk about what everybody else is talking about. A good source besides the hashtags, you know, our trends on Twitter would be just checking out Google Trends. Like, what's everybody searching for? And from that, you can check out the daily search trends. So on Sunday, May 3rd, yesterday, everybody was talking about Rick and Morty. I watched the Chicago Bulls Last Dance thing last night. So I see the Tony Kukoc was a big search. But then also today is actually May the 4th. So another idea that you can have to stay relevant is just talking about the different days. There's always a day for something. So May the 4th is Star Wars Day. So if there's a way that you can create whatever you want to be known for and write about it in relation to what that day is, that's what everybody's looking for anyway. So to stay relevant for what the topics are, another cheap way to do that is to look at daysoftheyear.com. Every day has got multiple days, so you can always pick one and write about it and try to relate that day back to whatever industry or brand you're trying to build for yourself. Another thing that you can check out is just frequently asked questions. Just FAQs for any industry, any company that you want to work for. Just Google or try to find their FAQs, because that's what everybody in the industry is trying to learn more about. So if you find those FAQs, I doubt anybody wants to work for the IRS, but if you do, check out their FAQs. So these are for that industry, for this website, what people are looking for. And if you go on here and you just find any one of these and just expand on it, you know, do a little research for yourself, write a little blog post. Blog posts don't have to be long. Add a picture, you know, use Instagram, use Fonto to add a picture to your blog and end up sharing it. You're going to get more conversation going there. Another thing that you can do is to try to keep things hyper-local, I guess. So just in your community, wherever you're wanting to live. Like right now, you guys are at Millikin, so you're in Decatur, or actually probably not since you're on the COVID working from home. But anyway, for the area that you're at, if you're wanting to get hired, if you guys move to Chicago, if you move to Bloomington Normal, we're always looking for talent, a lot of opportunities up here. Get involved in your community. So when I was saying about volunteering before, there's ways that you can use social media to really get involved in your community. One of them that I created a while ago, that's still running strong today, I handed over the admin tools, was actually called Decatur Co-Creators. And the concept was to find out who your local champions were and to share best practices so that we could basically come up with different ideas and try to get them implemented. And it worked. It was a really cool concept just to create this group of people who all really love their community and share thoughts and concepts. So one of them that I was really proud of in Decatur Co-Creators is downtown Decatur, there was Promax Construction, I believe they're still there. They had these wonderful planters that were sitting outside, and the Decatur celebration was coming up, and I parked down the street from the planters. I walked by them every day, and one day I came up and I noticed that somebody had actually vandalized them. So I was pretty upset about that, especially since they had spent so much money on these planters in front of their store, because it was, you know, it just basically beautified Decatur, and Decatur is hard enough to beautify as it is, and in my opinion, beauty is a right when it comes to a community. So we ended up coming on co-creators and said, hey, you know, it stinks that, you know, these things got busted. Is there anything that we can do about it? And somebody said, well, I'd, you know, pitch in some money if we want to fundraise. I was like, oh, that's a great concept. So we used one of the crowdfunding sources or one of the sites and just put a fundraising thing out there just to buy them new flower pots. And sure enough, we raised enough money to buy a couple, and we took the check in and let them know what we were doing. And they were so happy about it, they ended up buying new flower planters for the entire row of businesses. So it was a small little gesture from a lot of people that just cared about their community to go out and just do something about it. And it was just, it's nothing but time, it's voluntary efforts, it's where to share ideas. Another cool one was somebody had done a mural in downtown Decatur, and some artists were already on here, and they said, hey, you know, we need to do more murals. And I was like, we'd volunteer our time to do these murals if someone would just pay for the paint. And then I was like, well, I'm in economic development and I know a whole ton of people who own buildings. So let's play matchmaker. So from there, we actually created another group that was, I believe it's a Decatur mural project. And sure enough, we just started working with the art council there in Decatur and matching up artists with building owners. And now you can see how many murals are there in town, especially in the downtown area. And it started just off of a Facebook group like this. So it's just a matter of getting around like-minded people, talking about like-minded things. And for me, I just wanted to figure out a way to get people organized, get people that are all like-minded together, and to use social media for something positive. And it actually did a lot of big ripple effect throughout the community. Another one we did to start conversations was called the Decatur Cash Mob. That one is came and went. Whenever we turned it over, it kind of fizzled out. But the concept with the cash mob was that we really focus on buying local. And so with that, we would nominate different businesses. So everybody that was in the cash mob would try to find the harder to find businesses, because everybody knows about the Sonics. Everybody knows about Chipotle. Not everybody knows about the Lincoln Lounge and the Euros that are there, or Lock, Stock and Barrel. So we created the Cater Cash Mob. And the whole concept was that on Saturdays, you know, whenever they opened, we would just pick that place and everybody would mob the business and support local and take pictures. And whoever posted the best picture of their friends and family having a good time, we ended up partnering with the zoo, and I got free tickets to give them for the best picture. We also did a thing on Wednesdays that we would post a clue, and whoever guessed the clue would also get free tickets. I think it was to the Children's Museum or something like that. Something silly, but it was kind of a fun activity with the cash mob, because all these people would actually look forward to Wednesdays whenever we post the clue, and then it would create this conversation. And that's the takeaway with this right now, is that whatever you're posting, you want to create the conversation. I mean, getting likes is fine, but generating the comments down below is that's what you're looking for. You're looking for the comments. You're looking for people to share it so it gets expanded, because that's building your brand, spreading your message. And you can also do it for the opposite. So not just the good things, but we created another group that was called the Greater Decatur Debaters because we noticed a lot of people on the local media sites were just arguing with each other and bashing each other and trolling, basically. And we ended up creating this website that ended up becoming a private group, just so they could go somewhere and argue and get them off the main sites, because it just really looked bad for the community to have these people. I mean, every time there would be new news that was posted, WAD, Herald and Review, whatever, they get on there and just start tearing it apart. And so we would put it in this group and almost on purpose have people that were champions for the community go back and forth with them, just to keep it contained, because they know they're going to get more action in this group than they were going to get it on the regular media sites. So that was a way to try to control the message and the brand itself. And my brand was actually just to be a champion for Decatur, because in economic development, our role is to grow the community. And that's how I built my brand that way. And it really worked, because when I started my career, I was actually hired on for the Decatur, Macon County EDC, and I was hired in as the tech guy. I just knew how to build websites. And so I came in, was not paid a lot at all, but it was a great opportunity. And that is something I would suggest to you guys as well. Not only just the volunteering side of things, but just take whatever job you can get to get in the door and start building your brand from there. So I went into the EDC as managing their websites, learning the business slowly but surely, and then building this brand for myself using social media. Always being around the development to being the go-to for that kind of information. And then as I built that brand, as I graduated from Millikin, I moved up to vice president of business development. And then also ended up getting the job for the city of Decatur, because I built this brand that I used off of Instagram and other things in the community for the job that I wanted. And I wanted to, you know, work for the city of Decatur and learn more and do the other side of economic development, and slowly built that brand up. Using all the techniques that I talked about. So just to recap, you know, definitely start off with Instagram. There are different apps that are out there. I think I use Camera Plus to do some of these filters just to, you know, spice it up a little. Also, here's one of my football ones for whenever I was coaching over at LSA. Use Fonto to add the text to it. If you guys want to get into writing, Check out Medium, check out Tumblr is a really easy one, but then also WordPress if you want to be more professional. From there, subscribe to your own blog. Just Google blogging best practices or blogging ideas. There's so many that are out there. Days of the week are really easy just to create something. But then also, if you want to be known for being an expert in your field, check out the FAQs. What are people looking for? And then go from there. And if you want to get local, there's a lot of different ways to do it. A lot of best practices out there, especially now. But really build your brand and your writing off of the industry that you want to be in. And I still go back to three. Just stick with three. Don't narrow yourself down to one at this point. You guys are young. Actually, it doesn't really matter what age you are. I would say spread that around because I think range is very, very important. But I do suggest that you start somewhere and work your way up from there. Everyone I know starts off in one field and there's hardly anyone still in that field, unless they're doctors or lawyers, you know, they kind of stick with it. But everybody else, their career evolves the same way that mine did. I had no clue what economic development was whenever I knew that I wanted to be a art major and a graphic design, but it all ties together and along that journey, just as long as you continue learning, continue your education, and keep investing in yourself because that pays the biggest dividends. So for there, I'll go ahead and post this one. I'll probably do one more video because Candace did ask me to give advice to my younger self just in general. So I thought I'd do just a short bonus one and maybe some information that I probably should have started with, but I think it's better to come in the end after you've already digested some of this because I think it will assist. So until next time, good luck with your classes. Hope everybody is staying healthy.